Up top in the picture, we see a normal disc, and the normal disc is nice and plump and healthy, and it can be a shock absorber for the spine. I want you to pay attention to the width of this disc. So we're looking at this normal disc here and the width right here. Okay, so then we start to see degenerated disc, which is right here, this next level right here. So they've illustrated this by, it looks like it's cracking. But the point that we would see here is that if we take this intervertebral disc right here, okay, and let's go ahead and fill it with some water molecules. So we got a bunch of little water molecules kind of floating around in here. Well, over time, compressive forces, meaning the weight of your head, right, weighing down on your spine, the weight of your chest and your shoulders and your upper body is all weighing down on your spine. So the weight of all of these things, you pick up and carry backpacks and maybe children or puppies or whatever, you know, so you pick up heavy stuff, you move a couch, you know, all these things add up. And as you compress your spine, basically what's going to happen, and we really can't avoid it, and you know, this is just part of life. All things eventually do decay. You know, we're only meant to last for a certain number of years, and we really can't get around that. So one of the things that happens here with our spine is that these little water molecules will, under compression, so I'll draw in some compression here. So we've got force coming down on the spine, and or coming up, because jumping and landing really hard, that kind of stuff. So regardless, the force is the same. So we have forces that are pressing on this little fluid sac, right, in between the spine. And these little water molecules can't stand the pressure, and they leave, right? They will say, I am out of here, right? So we'll lose a little bit of water content. And, you know, it's, I want you to let this particular thing soak in for a second, that you lose this water content even over the course of one day. So when you wake up, you're taller than when you go to sleep, because the intervertebral discs have had time to decompress while you're sleeping. And so they've, you know, kind of soaked up some fluids and things like that. And there's some other things going on that when you decompress, and your posture kind of changes, and the muscles that are active kind of change and things like that. But when you get up in the morning, you are taller. And that just illustrates to me that even in the course of a single day, the compressive forces of just being alive and walking around and being upright and, you know, doing your thing, you don't even have to be, you know, lifting heavy weights or moving, you know, couches, and you don't have to be doing anything unusual. Just being awake and moving around is enough that your spine can, you know, your discs essentially get thinner throughout the day. So then think about what kind of forces, you know, what's going to happen if I was a weightlifter and I lifted 400 pounds, you know, I am nowhere near that strong, but a lot of people are able to do this, and they can put, you know, hundreds of pounds on a barbell, and they load it up where? On their necks. They put it on their neck. Imagine the compressive forces of that. And then for yoga, you know, I want you to think about, compressive forces don't have to just be straight down, right? Compressive forces can be on one side. So instead of having all these red arrows here, what if we had, there's some compression here, but what if we're doing a really a forward bend, and we're really putting a lot of pressure there? Then we're going to see that there's a lot of pressure on the front side of the spine right here, tons of pressure here, right? not so much near the back of the spine, but tons of pressure here, right? Lots of pressure on the front side, not so much on the back side. So you still will end up with some of this kind of thinning out and sort of degenerating effects on the structures by putting tons of pressure on one side. And by doing that, if we put a lot of pressure on one side, then you can imagine that it thins this side out, right? So the disc actually becomes thinner. And then as a result, the little jelly donut, which would be in the center, would bulge. So if there's a jelly donut in the center here, if there's if we're squishing on this end here, we squish, then this donut is going to go backwards. Yeah? And, well, look at which direction it's going and what it's running into. It's running into a nerve. It's going into the intervertebral foramen.